I know you guys are waiting on another video on this car, so here it is. Today, we're going to do the cooling system. On the last video, you saw that it ran, and that's really exciting, but what I want to do is pretty much go through the cooling system, make sure it's good before we actually get the car up to temp. And in a minute, I'm going to show you a couple reasons why. But first, I want you to check out another YouTube channel for me. His name is Ozstar. I'm going to put a link down in the description. Now, the crazy part about his channel is that he was working on a maroon-colored 1977 Corvette exactly like mine, except for his had been sitting less time, but he brought his back to life. So his is basically the same, but completely opposite, as in nothing's left stock on his car. The paint, the body, the interior, the motor, everything's been touched. But if you want to see another Corvette come back to life and get back on the road, go ahead and watch his channel. It's an awesome video series. I think he has 5 or 6 videos on it. Definitely worth your time. I decided to go ahead and fix up the cooling system. And let me show you first why. One is this fan clutch right here is completely seized, okay? So without that working properly, I don't think it's going to cool very well. Two, you can kind of see how bulged out this radiator hose is. I'm pretty sure they're original to the car, so we can change them. That's not that big of a deal. Another main reason is I can get all this stuff for about under $150. It's definitely worth the time. So we have a new fan clutch, we have a new brand new water pump, we have 2 upper and lower radiator hoses, we have a new thermostat and gasket. And then between that and flushing out the radiator, we should be pretty good when it comes to the cooling system. Hopefully we won't have much else to worry about. So let's go ahead and start pulling it apart. I'm going to drain it and then I'm going to start pulling pieces off and hopefully it will work out. The first step is going to be taking this cap off. It drains easier when you have it off. It just lets air back in the system while the water comes out the bottom. And speaking of water out the bottom, right here is where you drain the radiator from. Just a little plug in the bottom of the radiator, 9/16 socket, gets it all coming out. So I'm happy to see that the coolant coming out of that radiator is nice and green. Okay, it's not water, it's not really muddy, it looks pretty good. I'm gonna have to get myself another bucket because this one's filling up. So the fan clutch is out. It's just held on by 4 nuts and studs on there. Sometimes the studs come out with the nuts. Anyway, if you take a look at this fan clutch versus this one, I can't turn at all. Doesn't matter how I do it, it's pretty much frozen stuck. This one turns. So we know that the one that I have on the car is bad. Simple fix, take these 4 bolts out, the fan clutch drops out, put the fan then on your new one, 4 bolts in, boom, and you're done. But we're not that far yet because we have a whole bunch of other things to do. If you look, that was just step one. So next I'm going to do radiator hoses, then I'm going to take all these belts off, then take the water pump off. I will end up replacing these belts just because who knows how old they are, and now is a really good time to do it. I got the upper radiator hose and thermostat housing off. I'll show you those. Here's the hose. I'm curious to know if this is a factory hose, and the reason why, because it has this yellow stripe all the way down it. All the original vacuum lines for this car have a stripe that's similar. Different color, but similar. So I wonder if anybody can answer me that question. This, I don't think is factory, but you never know. Here's the thermostat housing. This is a control switch for the, there's an exhaust valve on the right side of the engine that opens and closes based on water temperature. And so that's what that is. So I'll clean that up and put all that back in. Those are expensive to replace, so try not to break them. And here's the thermostat. Pretty typical stuff. It's 195 degrees like it's supposed to be. It's not stuck open. I'm going to replace it just because I have it out. I'm pretty sure somebody's replaced that before because that's a lot of nasty silicone, but maybe not. Now it's going to be time to remove the water pump and the lower radiator hose, which is always a big mess. Lower radiator hose is off, and the last thing left to do is the water pump. And if you take a look at this crap, they're called mud daubers and they're everywhere in this car. I'm not really sure what kind of insect it is. I think it may be a wasp. Anyway, they make little nests, and then when they're gone, they leave them and they last forever. four more bolts, water pump comes off, and we are basically done tearing it apart, and we can start putting new stuff back on. Here we are with the water pump gone, and we're at the point where we can start putting stuff back on. I do want to show you this. Okay, so this is the stamp pad for the engine block. When people want to know if its numbers matching, what they usually are talking about is if there's a stamp on here that matches the VIN. I think it's the last six digits of the VIN is on this block. And mine is correct and matching. You can't see it, it's too dark in here. But that's what they want to know. And it's a good time to check it when you're doing all this and everything's out of the way. But this motor is original to this car, which is not surprising at all because, well, everything else is original too. So now we're going to pull out the water pump and get that ready to go back on. But first, what you need to do is you need to clean these gasket surfaces here and there so they're nice and clean and dry. Also, the thermostat housing. To get the new water pump ready for paint, you have to put the studs back, take the studs out of the old one and put it in the new one, and also this heater core outlet. So I could just leave this cast, but it will eventually rust. I don't have any Chevy blue paint because 77 was the first year for that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to paint it black. That way it won't be rusty. First, going to clean it with this, which is like the best stuff ever. Let it dry and then paint it. And while it's drying, I can go eat lunch. There it is. There's the new water pump installed. And I also did the thermostat and gasket. You look down there, there's a brand new lower radiator hose. So the trick with the lower radiator hose is you need to get it in and get it so it doesn't kink. So it took a little bit of massaging. I had to trim about half an inch off of one end. But it's definitely better than the old one. Here's the old one. I can't tell if this one's factory or not. It's pretty gross, but it does have part numbers on it. Wouldn't be surprised. And there's the front hose, or the top hose, excuse me. I'm gonna go ahead and put that on as well. This is how it goes sometimes when you're about to button up a project, you get stopped. Why? Because the parts don't fit. So if I line up this bottom hole right here, they don't fit. So they're too far out. It's about even right there. Obviously not gonna work, so I have to go back and return it and get another one. So I'm gonna have to get a whole different auto parts store, different brand something, because the ones I've seen online are all the same. So those go there. I'm gonna take the time to go ahead and buy the new belts and buy a bunch of other little new things that, you know, probably haven't been done in a long time. The breather for the crankcase, which goes to the end of this. I'm going to buy a new PCV valve. I'm going to buy a new radiator cap. I'm going to buy a new air filter completely. I'm going to get a new cap and rotor. So just little things that I know that haven't been touched in a long time. But yeah, that's as far as we're going to get on this video. I think I'm going to go ahead and continue on the brakes, get those going, since I'm sitting here waiting anyway. I have the water pump up on the vise, and if you look at the bottom of it, there's a weep hole. It's hard to see. It's in there. But it's been leaking, and you can tell by looking at the inside of the pulley that goes on top of the water pump. So this pump probably still pumped, but it leaked. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take off this back cover and show you guys what the inside of the pump looks like. I will end up keeping this pump. I'm not going to, you know, scrap it or anything. It's going to go with the car in case the next owner wants to put the original, you know, water pump on the car, he can. But I'm going to take it apart and show you guys inside. You guys ready? Ta-da! So, as expected, it's pretty gross inside. I mean, 40 years of sitting, or 40 years of water inside something. Guess what? That's what it's going to look like. Now, the seal that goes bad is the shaft seal down deep inside of there. You can't have this rebuilt. I'm not going to, because the new one that I put on has a different style impeller. And that is actually a better style, and it pumps a little bit more water. So this is probably what the inside of the engine block looks like, but you know what? It looks like this on every single 40-year-old Corvette. That's just what they look like. Cast iron and water for that much time, it's going to look like that. But we replaced it, so It's all better now. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw that in the box for the next guy. I had something really cool happen. So I got a fan clutch to fit, but I didn't go and buy it new. I actually got it out of another parts car that I got. Let me go ahead and show you. You guys probably think I'm crazy, but I did get another parts car. This one is really sad. Supposedly it had been sold at Meekum in the past. It was a really nice car, really nice paint, but it got smashed right in the front. You can already see how badly it got hit. Look at the way the front suspension is. One A-arm's there, another A-arm's all the way over here. Let me show you the big kink in the frame that happened. Check that out. So this, let me show you on the 77. Is supposed to look like this. A nice curve goes up to the front suspension and it's destroyed. So yes, there were still good parts on this car. I'm in the process of stripping it. It was an original factory 81, so if you need things like connectors and cruise control crap and all that kind of stuff, let me know. The inside was pretty much gone when I got it, but on the floor was the radiator fan and that fan clutch. I was like, yes, that's like $40 I don't have to spend on the other car from this car. So that's good. Yeah, it's a really nice car. It's a shame. I wanted to make like a little C3 trailer out of it, but the frame's just so messed up that it's like, probably not worth my time. As of now, the water pump is in, the new belts are on, the new fan clutch is in, new thermostat and gasket is in, bottom hose is in. I also got a radiator cap, a good condition radiator cap from that parts car. Awesome, saved me $6. And all that's left for the cooling system is going to be the upper hose and then to add coolant. But before I do that, what I want to do is, since I have, for example, this hose undone and a lot of stuff out of the way, I want to pull the valve covers, one, to clean them up, but two, I want to replace the gaskets, because you can tell these valve covers are leaking like crazy. And they're going to continue to leak. I have new gaskets for it, so now's as good a time as any to go ahead and do it. I can also check out the valve train, see if anything's broken or missing. I don't think so, because the engine doesn't miss. First valve cover is off. Things that I look for bent push rods, loose rocker arms. I look for all the rocker arms have oil on them, which is good. It's not as bad under here as I thought it was going to be. A little sludgy, but not too bad. Here's the inside of the valve cover. Just a little bit, but you can see where it's been leaking all along this edge. See how it's coated? The gaskets are probably from 1977, so it's time to change them. Luckily, it's a pretty easy swap. I recommend trying to keep all the crap out of the head as you can. So you might put a few paper towels down the oil drain holes. When you pull the gasket and stuff like that. Vacuums are great for stuff like this because it sucks most of it up. When I put on a gasket, I use a really thin coat of RTV on both sides. And yeah, but hey, I'm happy with this side for sure. Here's the driver's side. Very, very similar. Same kind of issue with the cork gasket at the bottom leaking. All the rockers look good. They're all oily, so there's no, you know, loose push rods or anything like that. So I think we're good. Yep. Another straight up job. The only difference on this side is there's a lot less stuff to take off in order to get everything on. So the other side cleaned up pretty well. I'll go ahead and show that to you. Once I get this car out of the garage, I plan on power washing the engine bay. But if you look, the valve cover actually cleaned up pretty well. So I'm hoping the other side will be about the same. The valve covers are on. The cooling system is all buttoned up and full. It has all brand new antifreeze in it. It's gonna go down obviously when the engine runs. What I wanna do is I wanna get the engine to temp, and I only wanted to do that after I looked at the cooling system. Well, now it's pretty much all done. You see this now moves really nice. And I took the opportunity to replace the cap and rotor, so the ignition system should be done. So it should fire right up. I made sure the weights in the distributor were free for the vacuum advance. I need to check transmission fluid once it gets hot. Let's go.
sure that I don't see any real big active oil leaks coming from the valve covers. Both sides. The other side's a little bit more smoky than this side. Also need to make sure I have no fuel leaks. I need to make sure I have no water leaks. I look good on there. Idling right at about 900 RPM. I'm gonna watch this temp gauge. Now we got some smoke coming from here, but I think it's just residual. This one was the worst of the two. We'll let it burn off and see what it does. So, the car is idling a little high. I'll have to deal with that a little bit later. But the car is at temperature because the copper hose is hot and it is pressurized. I put in about 2 quarts of transmission fluid. So, not bad. Considering there's probably a leak. We are at, let's see, right underneath 200, which is great. That's operating temp. So we're within, and we're right where we need to be. So I'm going to call that good. I've noticed down here on the manifold, you can see some of the crud that's burning away. It's smoking a lot less. You probably can't see this on camera, but it is smoky in here. I'm pretty sure it's just all the stuff burning up. So there it is. It ran for a good 15 minutes. Still smoke coming from this side. And last but not least, new air cleaner, new crankcase filter. Just because it needed it. Basically the only reason. So I'm going to go ahead and clean up the top of this, and then next we're going to do is the brakes. They're halfway done. I got everything apart and everything ordered. I just need to assemble them and then put the interior back in.